Ni ho everyone, this is Alana here with Honkai Impact Free Storyline Explained in 10 Minutes by Funshiki. I'm really curious about this because, as you guys know, I like to watch Honkai Impact animations all that, and I've been playing the game, but I'm still very far behind in the game. So I thought, like, I saw this in my suggestion list, that one of you have suggested, and I, you know, you said to myself, you know what, I'm gonna watch this and get a little bit, at least, about Honkai Impact, and see if I can merge all of this information into my brain. That's the question. I tend to forget easily, so I'm very sorry for that. And, yeah. This video was originally released in September 2018, so some information may be outdated. Still, probably more information and more ideas than I have, because I'm dumb. I don't remember anything. I remember watching that.
漫画动画和小说质量也相当出众，但由于繁杂的背景设定和混乱的剧情顺序，导致诸多玩家即使感兴趣也只能望而却步。然而很多人不知道的是，经过两年的积累后，今天的崩坏三已经逐渐形成了一个相对完整且有趣的剧情体系。从之前的完全不知道他讲什么，好像可以知道他在讲什么。但是崩坏三两周年的契机，今天就让范世在各位见长。
Oh God! I can relate to that. I feel like every time I dive into a game story or something like that, especially something that is very big and very complex, it's like I start to understand it partially. In chronological order of every captain up. The most epic comment on ever. I'm sorry, I should continue. Oh God.
地球上有一种名为崩坏的星球，毁灭人类的文明。灾害、瘟疫、怪兽都可以看作是崩坏意志的不同化身。其中级别最高的崩坏会在人身上诞生名为绿者的超级生命。是不是来着？我也很久。编号，比如第一次崩坏、第二次崩坏等等。人类中有两个对抗崩坏和绿者的组织，天命和逆商。前者靠考古，后者靠科技。而崩坏三就是一个关于天命和逆商互相撕逼。 顺便对抗一下崩坏的故事。对，当然我的时候就好。接下来为了叙述方便，我将剧情分为五个重要的时间节点：5万年前的史前纪元，公元15世纪的中世纪末期；1952年的第一次崩坏；2000年的第二次崩坏；和2014年的第三次崩坏。绝大部分的崩坏三衍生作品都是围绕这五个时期展开的。Man. 5万年前，上一代人类已经建立起一个高度发达的文明，并开发出诸多对抗崩坏的方法。其中一种就是在击败绿者后将。
Or should I say cold? I don't know, because ice, whatever. Okay, so 50,000 years. Oh shit. Huh. Man, that's a long ass time ago. I can tell you that. So that makes sense, because I know some of you guys mentioned that Fuhua is like 50,000 years old. And I guess that makes sense then, that back then they had, seemingly as I can see here, like really advanced, and I mean super weapons even, technology. And then I assume, considering 50,000, wait, isn't that pretty much when humans started, the Homo sapiens started to appear, something like that? Like, way in the Stone Age before. So I guess that means that literally everything got wiped out, and then we have the steps of evolution that we had, that we know about, so to speak. We went through the Stone Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age, Disease Age, oh shit, Religion Age, oh no, Plague Age, And yeah, you know, the entire thing that we had up to today. Okay.
Kevin
and Fuhua. It sounds even more fun because one of my little brothers is named Kevin. So every time someone's like, oh, Kevin is so cool, so I instantly, my brain half that shouldn't think, thinks like, oh, my little brother.
被秘密冷冻在睡眠舱里帮助下个纪元外，其余所有的人类都灭亡了。
Yeah. That looked like Nier Automata Desert, you know? Because I've been playing it a lot now on my channel, for those that want to check it out. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Yeah, because I remember that Kevin also is like this super old. So they were like, put in a freezer, man.
在漫画中对应这段剧情的是几篇因为时之剑秘画的短篇外传，大多是以旁白视角展开的纯说明文，篇幅不多，但信息量极大，基本可以通过疯狂补设定，是崩学家研究崩坏史的重要文献。其中也有很多人物关系上的小彩蛋，比如魅影博士和第七律者Himeko跟牙医和姬子在长相、言语发音上。Himeko，哟吼。
They share the same look and names with Mei and Himeko. Oh, really, do they? Yeah. Can I say that Himeko looks really hot? For many reasons. Part of it involves fire.
完全一致，可以看成是轮回转世。手持天火圣裁的 Kevin 卡斯兰娜，可以看成是 Kiana 的老祖宗，而5万年前烛火之额的融合战士华，则可以看作是浮华的本人。我操！<laughs>
Can I say I love this guy's humor and all of that? Oh man. And you know what? I'm gonna admit, back when I was young and I heard Chinese for the like first time, I thought it was just weird. It made language, it made no sense to me. And it still doesn't make sense to me. I mean, I don't understand pretty much anything right off the spot like this. But I think it's a pretty cool language. I would actually like to learn that. A little bit Chinese. I would like to learn many languages. Languages are cool. I would say. I say. Oh, jag kan ju prata svenska med. That sounds so weird. When I've been speaking English for quite a while and then jump over to Swedish, it sounds just weird.
Well,
I fell in love. I mean, that's nice. Okay. So, Callan and Odo there, they kind of split up because Odo started to do kind of questionable experiments and stuff. And Fuhua. So Fuhua had been awakened then already? In the 1500s? And I kind of like the idea how they mix up the different, you know, regions. I mean, you have like witches, I would assume, based on like the Crusades by the Christianity. The Valkyries, okay, from Norse mythology. You had the Ming Dynasty from China and all of that. And I honestly think that is pretty neat, you know? I love history. And seeing that using, you know, making their own thing out of it, I think that's interesting. And I love this image. Ah, damn furry wheel. Oh man, she got nailed. Oh. That sucks.
结束了其波澜壮阔的一生，在漫画中对应这时期的按顺序是紫渊篇、绯音篇和黑白版的八道十一画。但因为实际的更新时间跨度非常大，绯音篇甚至比紫渊篇早了足足三年，所以连起来看堪称大型吃书现场。比如游荡十月从造出来的变成挖出来的，奥托从真好用万能黑木男变成友情友谊真男人，卡莲则从国民女神华丽变身大号天堂大树家。这要不就是美国的基因，是因为他通过第一神之剑虚空万丈的力量学到了上一文明纪元的知识，利用更换肉体不停续命的。 技术，他连任了500年的天命主教，最终成为了今天的幕后大boss。除了对卡莲扭曲的爱，他也做了很多疯狂的举动，比如用卡莲和崩坏兽的 DNA 合成了德丽莎阿波卡利斯，以及自主。
Yeah, there is all this. Ah, man, dude. Okay, the Kalen, Kalen fantasy. Oh man, but seeing all of this merged together like this. All the information that, because I have gotten like told about this, like Cal. Oh shit! Someone's calling me. Who the fuck? Who calls me? I don't have. Oh, it's my dad. Man, family calling me. I don't understand. Also, I like to say Somi Game Station 3 : Fantasy. I like that.
奥托相亲相爱，暴打八重印的电子游戏《Kalen Fantasy》成绩不是排行榜第一，并在Cecilia的分数超过他后，把他的号封了。
He froze her.
时间继续推进，来到现代，2022年的第一次崩坏在柏林发生。产生第一律者名叫瓦尔特，但他却莫名失去了记忆，并没有像上古文献中记载的那样对人类产生敌意。天命组织也不知如何是好，只能把他捉回去做人体实验。在这期间，瓦尔特结识了爱因斯坦、特斯拉、普朗克等一批不知为何都是美少女的天命科学家，和这群圣痕过了一段后宫片。Harem
is life, man. Einstein and Tesla, they look mighty fine, I would say.
在幸福生活后，他们逐渐发觉了组织的阴暗面，最终和奥托彻底决裂，从天命出走，成立了逆商组织。对于这段剧情的衍生作品，主要是名为《逆商》的视觉小说，和漫画不同，是文字类载体，所以信息量非常大。详细阐述了崩坏、魂钢、史前文明等诸多概念。在剧情上也是崩坏三中非常精彩的一章。顺带一提，系列中一共出现过四名瓦尔特，而漫画的瓦尔特乔伊斯就是逆商小说的主角，也是原声的第一律者。但在对抗奥托的过程中牺牲，临死前他将律者核心传给了一个小男孩，他就是赫曼的瓦尔特杨，也是。
Meldu got stepped on by me.
而后面被牙医脚踩的瓦伊特，被浮夸吊打的瓦尔。Ooh,
that's gonna hurt. But I knew it. Fins, they have the headshots. I should know that.
则是乔伊斯的克隆人。第一律者真正的能力是理智律者，只要明白了事物的原理，就可以将其再现。所以瓦伊特和瓦尔特控制重力的能力来源，其实是他们所克隆的初代瓦尔特的肌肉记忆里再现了的第九神之剑伊甸之心中所封印的第九律者核心炎之律者的能力。我操，这是太他妈复杂了。Yeah,
dude, you heard in my brain, man. That's very complicated. So it's the clone and the. No wonder I don't remember anything. My brain is overloaded.
说完了第一次崩坏，接下来就到了负责承上启下的重要节点。2000年发生在西伯利亚的第二次崩坏，是一段一开始只活在旁白中的剧情。卡斯兰娜家的齐格菲和 S 级女神Cecilia结婚，生下的女角 Kiana。由于奥托第二律者西林同归于尽，愤怒的齐格菲带着Kiana出逃，然后就没了。即使是游戏中专门讲这段的第5、第6章，也只是情怀式的让岳父岳母露了个脸。然而最新的连载漫画第二次崩坏，I
like it. They all appear to please the fans, like damn straight. We want to.
中对这段剧情进行了非常详实的补完，将其升级成一场多方势力角逐的史诗级战役，尤其是逆商阵营，又是弑神武器，又是无限剑制，最后神他妈黑洞都造出来了，简直狂刷存在感。反观游戏里超级活跃的，Dude,
with a black hole, they can, didn't steal just a spotlight. They literally stole the light. Fun fact: black holes are actually not black. They don't have any color at all. It's just that they absorb the light, so it looks like they're black. I read somewhere. I might be wrong, but very interesting. But then again, Black Hole sucks. I can honestly say I love his humor.
One thing
for sure I need to subscribe to this guy. This was awesome. It described quite a lot, and I must say I love this guy's humor and all of that. And I can even imagine there's lots that is missed for me that is not speaking Chinese. But really, really well made. I love this. And given quite a lot, actually, about like Kevin, Fuha, Otto, Kessler, and all of these things. And in general, you know, I mean, it's obviously that the story in the game and the manga novels, oh god. Oh my god, why are there so many things? My brain can't handle that. I get stroke. Oh my god, this was awesome though. And I will be back with more Honkai Impact. And since this seem to be more parts, I'm gonna try to watch them as well. So thank everyone for watching. See you later on. And of course, check out Fun Cheeky for more amazing content. Because if they are half as good as this, they're gonna be great.